further.
Also, a little bit later, we got additional data from different maps for Ukrainians, and according to pre-Ukrainian sources, the Russians managed to reach the outskirts of the little but not to answer the event. So this report was posted yesterday evening, and later we got additional information from different mappers, including the Russians. And as for the Russian sources, they sent them at 8 a.m., 7, 8 a.m. at the local time. The Russian sources published the map, additional map, that the Russian system of the Russians managed to establish complete control over the Belitsinovka and to answer the outskirts of Belitsinovka. So this is Belitsinovka, the village of Belitsinovka, and this is the village of Belitsinovka. So answer the truth right before we make, I start making the video, most of these territories were colored as in gray and were contested, were considered as contested area. Right before I started the video, 2 seconds before, we got another video from most likely 114th brigade and motorized brigade and also Russian Federation. And in this video we can see how the Russians fully answered the central part of the city and raised the Russian flag. So currently we have no doubt that the Russians have to move over, but the Russians established complete control over the village, and most likely nothing can stop the Russians from the progress of the southeastern, south and southwestern direction. The Ukrainian says that they also suffer significant growth problems, and most likely now the Ukrainians have bunkered oxygen to stabilize the situation. Currently, nobody thinks about the stabilization of the situation. Currently, everyone thinks about one thing: how to save as many as possible, and how to avoid encirclements, how to access in times of war, and many other problems. So, as you can see, the situation for the Ukrainians, especially for those forces who are currently located between these fields, is becoming vital and critical. Ukrainians need to begin running away, not to defend the position, but running away from this territory as soon as possible. They should have started doing this already, and they should start with this already yesterday, and maybe a week ago. If they haven't started doing this yet, then there are very high chances that these units can be encircled here in the whole. So this is the situation, and once again, let's make some projections a little bit. So according to this, according to these progress, according to latest geofishes, most likely the Russians are going to continue moving along the road between Giumki and Mikhailovka, so Sivudova, and they will try to take under control everything that goes right inside in this area, this small polygon that I'm adding on maps. All these territories most likely would be captured by the Russians in the next 24, 48 hours, and then the main battle will start going forces. coming with the Russian staff until they are able to support us. Furthermore, sources reported that the Ukrainians intensified the evacuation process for the siege of Krakow and suffered recent hundreds of more than generally around the Russian Federation. Now let's move to the Tayetsk Federation and as for this territory, we have lots of very interesting pictures. Yes, we have a lot of fire anomalies. For example, this is a number of fire anomalies over the entire New York and Tayetsk, and the most important fire anomalies coming from this part. So something is happening here. I mean, this is something like an evidence that we have.